Now, we were here finding out the solutions for quadratic equations, and the next procedure or the next way to find out the solutions of a quadratic equations is completing of squares. In completing of squares, I'll tell you how to solve all these equations by completing of squares with an example. And that example is 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. First of all, see, this is a quadratic equation, correct? Now we will find the solution to this quadratic equation by completing of squares. So I'll take you through the steps via this example, and then we'll just perfect this method with other examples, okay? So the first step in completing of squares is to make the coefficient of x square equal to 1. So how do we do that? We divide this equation by 2. If we divide the equation by 2, the coefficient of x square would be 1, correct? So the equation becomes x square minus 5 by 2x plus 3 by 2 equal to 0. Right? This is what the equation becomes. Now, if you see correctly, I'll just write this equation equal to something, and then I'll tell you how did I write that. If you see over here, x square minus 5 by 2x plus 3 by 2 is equal to x minus 5 by 4 whole square minus 5 by 4 square plus 3 by 2. Here. Now, how did I write this? To write this, what do you have to do is, if you see over here, we take x from there, because we always have the coefficient of x square equal to 1, we've already done that. We take x from there, then we take half of the coefficient of x, okay? Half of coefficient of x along with its sign. If it is minus 5 by 2, correct? The coefficient of x is minus 5 by 2. So we write over here minus 5 by 4. And we take the whole square of this. And then we take another term that is again the half of the coefficient of x and write it with a minus sign over here and square it. That is minus 5 by 4 square plus 3 by 2 is as it is. Now if you open this bracket, it will become, I'm just doing this in the rough to explain you how did I reach this. This bracket over here becomes x square minus 2 into x into 5 by 4, correct, plus 5 by 4 whole square, correct. This is what this bracket will become, right? Now this bracket has another 5 by 4 minus 5 by 4 whole square plus 3 by 2 over here, right? This is what this part over here has. Now if you see over here, this becomes x square minus, this 2 goes with this 2, minus 5 by 2x, correct? This and this gets cancelled, and this is plus 3 by 2. So this is equal to this, correct? So the way to write this equation into this form is the key over here. So how do you do that? First of all, you write x and then take the coefficient of x, take its half and write it with the sign over here. Now if this would have been x, the equation would have been x square plus 5x plus 3, then over here there would have been x square plus 5 by 2x plus 3 by 2, right? Then over here there would have been x plus 5 by 4 square whole square minus 5 by 4 square plus 3 by 2. You have to take the half of the coefficient of x along with the sign in this square. Okay. So x minus half of the coefficient of x along with the sign square minus half of this, again, this sign will always be minus. Okay. Because in squares, both the formulas, we have a plus b whole square and a minus b whole square. The term of b square in the expansion is always positive, correct? So to compensate that term, we have this term. So that is always going to be equal to b square, or the square of the or the half of the coefficient of x and taken its square with the minus sign, correct? So minus 5 by 4 square plus 3 by 2. This is how we write this. Now from here we will find the solution of this quadratic equation. Now I'll tell you how to do that. So we've reached till here. So this we know now that the solution of this equation is also the solution of this equation, correct? Now this equation becomes x minus 5 by 4 whole square minus 25 by 4 plus 3 by 2 equal to 0. Okay, now we'll just add these two up. This will become x minus 5 by 4 minus, sorry, this is 25 by 16, not 4. 25 by 16 because it is 5 by 4 whole square. So this is equal to 16 minus 25 plus 24 equal to 0. So we have x minus 5 by 4 whole square is equal to 1 by 16. This is where we've reached now. Now what do we do from here is we take this square to this side and take its root. So this is going to be equal to x minus 5 by 4 is equal to, now the square term is gone, is equal to plus minus under root of 1 by 16, correct? We take a plus minus sign whenever we take the root from there to this side. So this is x minus 5 by 4 plus minus 1 by root of 1 by 16. So now what do we do is we take this root. This is equal to x minus 5 by 4 is equal to plus minus 1 by 4. Correct? Okay. Now we have two solutions to this equation. First is x minus 5 by 4 equal to 1 by 4 and x minus 5 by 4 equal to minus 1 by 4. Am I right? So now we will solve these two. We have x equal to 5 by 4 plus 1 by 4 and x equal to 5 by 4 minus 1 by 4, right? So from here, x is going to be equal to 4 upon 6, 6 upon 4, and over here, x is equal to 4 upon 4. So x is either equal to 3 by 2 and x is equal to 1. So these are the two solutions to the quadratic equation 2x square minus 5x plus 3 equal to 0. So the only catch in completing of squares is to write this step. If you know how to write this step, you will always be able to find the solution.